In this video, I'm going to answer what is ankylosing spondylitis, its common symptoms, progression, and how it's diagnosed. Hey everyone, Dr. Rowe here at SpineCare in St. Joseph, Michigan. If you're unsure of what ankylosing spondylitis, commonly known as AS, is, it's an autoimmune rheumatic condition that primarily affects the spine as well as other joints throughout the body. To help explain it a bit better, I'm going to break it down into three parts: causes, symptoms, and how it's commonly diagnosed. So to begin with, let's talk more about the cause of ankylosing spondylitis. Going back to AS being a rheumatic condition, that means that there's a condition in which your immune system has developed a fault, goes awry, and begins to attack your own tissues. This is also referred to as an autoimmune disease. Many of these conditions are considered idiopathic or of unknown cause. Sometimes it's the genes you're born with, other times it's the result of something that affects you directly, like something that causes an infection. As of today, doctors and researchers are stumped on what exactly causes AS, which also means there is no known cure. However, it is known that genetics play a very important role, especially with a gene called HLA-B27. This is important to note. Most people who have AS also have a gene that produces a protein called HLA-B27. I want to note though, being a HLA-B27 gene carrier does not mean a person will develop ankylosing spondylitis. Less than 1 in 20 people with HLA-B27 gets AS. It's just an important link to the development of the condition. Also, HLA-B27 isn't the only genetic marker linked with AS, since researchers suspect more than 60 different genes have been associated with AS. Particular environmental factors like a viral or bacterial infection may also be needed to activate AS. There's also research that may link intestinal bacteria as the trigger of the disease. Additionally, the majority of those diagnosed with ankylosing spondylitis are Caucasian males under the age of 45. Women can also have the disease, but men are twice as likely to get it. Again, there is no known cause or cure to AS, but research is making headway on possible triggers and early detection signs that may help treat it with greater success. So next, let's go over the common symptoms of AS in better detail. Just like any condition or disease, the development of ankylosing spondylitis, including the onset of symptoms, can vary significantly from one person to the next. However, most symptoms will start to develop in late adolescence or early adulthood. In more rare cases, it's possible to see symptoms start early in childhood. The most common early symptoms include frequent dull pain and stiffness around the lower back or buttocks. The pain will gradually become more severe and frequent over the course of weeks to months. Initially, the discomfort is felt on one side, then may suddenly alternate sides. The pain is usually spread out or diffuse instead of pinpoint or localized. Pain and stiffness is usually worse in the mornings and during the night or after any long periods of inactivity. It's usually relieved by heat, such as a warm shower, or with light stretches and exercises. Other early stages of AS include mild fever, loss of appetite, and an overall general discomfort. This is because back pain and other symptoms from ankylosing spondylitis are caused by increased inflammation in the body that is being produced due to the autoimmune disease. As AS progresses, the pain usually becomes more frequent and chronic, and at this point is usually felt on both sides. Random flare-ups of discomfort and significant pain can last for several weeks. Over the course of months or years, the stiffness and pain may slowly work its way up into the spine and into the neck. It's possible the pain and tenderness may spread to the ribs, shoulder blades, hips, and ankles. The major hallmark sign of ankylosing spondylitis is pain and stiffness in the sacroiliac or SI joints that progressively gets worse. The SI joints are located at the base of the spine where the spine joins the pelvis. A classic symptom is when the SI joints start to hurt more at night and get better when you wake up and start to move around. Fatigue is another common symptom, again from the inflammation being caused by AS. The body must spend energy to fight inflammation, which leads to fatigue. Also, it may cause mild to moderate anemia due to the inflammation, which can lead to the feeling of being tired and lethargic. Other symptoms of ankylosing spondylitis may include bowel inflammation and eye or vision issues. As ankylosing spondylitis progresses into the later stages, the buildup of chronic inflammation can lead to a condition known as ankylosis, hence the name, which bony formations start to appear in the spine and cause vertebra to fuse together in a locked, fixed position. Also, the ribcage can undergo calcification and fusion, which makes breathing difficult. One of the most serious complications of ankylosing spondylitis in its later stages is the development of a hyperkyphotic hunchback posture. It's commonly seen with individuals who poorly manage or completely leave the condition untreated. Why this happens is because as AS progresses, the spine becomes stiff and rigid, slowly leading into a head forward position. This position, not only being considered unsightly, may severely impact the range of motion of the neck and the back, leading to decreased quality of life. Postural exercises and maintaining good posture, without a doubt, is important at this point. So what diagnostic tests are available to detect and diagnose ankylosing spondylitis? The first steps are working with your doctor to have a comprehensive physical exam, blood work, including testing for HLA-B27, and imaging such as x-rays being performed. Also take into account individual medical history and any family history of AS, as these are important factors in making a diagnosis. Here are some key factors in helping to diagnose it. First, onset before 45 years of age. Chronic pain that persists for more than 3 months. Back pain and stiffness made worse with inactivity, especially at night and in the morning. Back pain and stiffness that gets better with light activity and exercise. Changes in normal back and neck range of motion, inflammation and tenderness around the spine and pelvis, and any eye or bowel issues may help give clues too. Going back to what I mentioned earlier, since it's a big factor, the hallmark sign of AS is the involvement of the sacroiliac or SI joints. X-rays can show sacroiliitis, or erosion of the SI joints due to chronic inflammation. Sacroiliitis is extremely common with AS, especially during its early stages. Sacroiliitis caused by this tends to be symmetrical, affecting both sides. Another important sign on an x-ray is the formation of syndesmophytes, which are thin, bony projections that stick out from the corners of the vertebra. As AS progresses, it can start moving up the spine, leading to spinal joints becoming inflamed and syndesmophytes forming, eventually bridging and fusing two or more vertebra together. The end result of this process, as seen on an x-ray, is a radiographic feature called bamboo spine due to its similar appearance. A third radiographic sign is the squaring of lumbar vertebra. They may appear abnormally square from the erosion during the inflammatory phase. With all this, you can see how x-rays are extremely vital to doctors in helping to diagnose ankylosing spondylitis. So what's the next step if you've been diagnosed with AS? Most people will end up working with a doctor that specializes in autoimmune disorders and arthritis, called a rheumatologist. A rheumatologist will set up a treatment plan that may include medications such as NSAIDs, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and prescribing physical and occupational therapy to help manage the symptoms. Many patients also follow an anti-inflammatory diet and find relief with chiropractic treatments, acupuncture, massage, and yoga. At-home exercises, especially those that focus on maintaining posture, are also beneficial. So if you have been diagnosed with AS, make sure to consult with your doctor or your rheumatologist about treatment options and possible ways to help limit inflammation. If you like the video and it helped you out, please show us your support by giving this video a like and maybe subscribing to our channel too. We appreciate it, and thanks for watching.